The Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor is considered to be the most potent fighter in the world. But it had one major flaw. It couldn't communicate with other platforms seamlessly. The U.S. military is very much aware of it, and things are now going to change. 13 years after entering service with the U.S. Air Force, the F-22 Raptor will be able to voicelessly communicate with warships, ground forces, and other jets. The U.S. Air Force and Lockheed Martin plans to start installing Link 16 datalink to Raptors in 2020. The full fleet of F-22, roughly 180, will have this installed in a phased manner. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why adding Link 16 datalink to F-22 Raptor will be a game changer for the U.S. military. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles, from the 1930s to the 1990s, and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor is a fifth-generation, single-seat, twin-engine, all-weather, stealth tactical fighter aircraft developed for the United States Air Force. The result of the USAF's Advanced Tactical Fighter Program. The aircraft was designed primarily as an air superiority fighter, but also as a ground attack, electronic warfare, and signal intelligence capabilities. F-22 is the first operational aircraft to combine supercruise and supermaneuverability. Supercruise is the ability to have sustained supersonic flight without having to use the highly inefficient afterburners. With this, F-22 can intercept targets which subsonic aircraft would lack the speed to pursue, and an afterburner-dependent aircraft would lack the fuel to reach. F-22 incorporates supermaneuverability, which makes it a capable dogfighter. Its agility can be gauged from the fact that it can pull off highly demanding aerial maneuvers like Pugachev's Cobra. This is possible due to very powerful dual Pratt & Whitney F-119 PW-100 afterburning turbofan engines. The engine can be considered as an engineering marvel, since American rivals are still finding it difficult to develop something like this. Russian Su-57 is facing issues in this department and using AL-41 F-1 engine used in Su-35. The serial production of more powerful engine, known as the Izdelai 30, has seen multiple delays. Even with that, it might not be able to supercruise at more than Mach 1.6. Chinese J-20 uses Russian AL-31F engines, which is the predecessor of the AL-41 F-1 and has till now struggled to make an indigenous engine suitable for a fifth-generation aircraft. F-22 Raptor is developed from the ground up to be stealthy. F-22 is the stealthiest fighter ever built and has very low RCS, that's radar cross-section, of only 0.0001 square meter. It achieves this due to its structural design as well as the use of radar-absorbing materials. It can't be detected by most radars, so it can strike without the enemy knowing it was there in the first place. China and Russia have found it very difficult to master stealth even today. Reports have emerged that Sukhoi Su-30 MKI of the Indian Air Force managed to detect the Chinese Chengdu J-20 jet fighter. To know more, check the video on the above card. This elevates doubts about the Chinese fighter, which was already regarded as a decorated 4++ generation fighter by many experts. India last year decided to stop working with Russia on the fifth generation fighter aircraft program, or FGFA. FGFA was deemed to be an improved and customized variant of Su-57. One of the main reasons for this is that the Su-57 was found to have suspect stealth capabilities that can't be fixed with small changes. As per some analysis, Su-57 has an RCS of 0.01 meters squared, which makes it around 100 times larger on the radar when compared to F-22. One of the most important aspects of a fighter aircraft is its radar. Radars are like the eyes for them. There was no budget limitation when the AN/APG-77 radar was developed for F-22 Raptor. No compromises were made, and this keeps it at the top even today. The AN/APG-77 radar features a low observable, active aperture, electronically scanned array that can track multiple targets under any weather conditions. It has a range of around 400 kilometers against a 1 square meter target. This radar can also be used for electronic attack by focusing its signals on the enemy to overload their sensors. The radar changes frequency more than 1,000 times per second to resist jamming and has low probability of intercept, meaning that the enemy has no warning that a radar lock has been achieved against it. With AN/APG-77, F-22 Raptor can gather a lot of data, and some experts have said that the Raptor pilot has God's eye view of the battle space. But Raptor can't share this view with other platforms, and this is where Link 16 comes in. Link 16 is a military tactical data link network used by the U.S., NATO, and nations allowed by the MIDS International Program Office. Its specification is part of the family of tactical data links. With Link 16, military aircraft, as well as ships and ground forces, may exchange their tactical picture in near real time. Link 16 also supports the exchange of text messages, imagery data, and provides two channels of digital voice, 2.4 kilobits and/or 16 kilobits in any combination. Link 16 data communication standards and technology were developed in the U.S. JTIDS program, which began in 1975. The first JTIDS terminals, or Class 1 terminals, were large and were installed only on AWACS and in U.S., U.K., and NATO ground control facilities. Smaller JTIDS terminals, Class 2, were also developed. But these were still bulky and pretty costly, which prevented wide-scale deployment. Only a few fighters were equipped with these. Then the MIDS program was created to put small, lightweight Link 16 terminals on the U.S. and participating allies' fighter aircraft. Under MIDS, low-volume terminal and fighter data link terminals were acquired, and this provided the ability to have Link 16 in fighters like F-15, F-16, and FA-18. Link 16 is a TDMA-based secure, jam-resistant, high-speed digital data link which operates in the radio frequency band of 960 to 1215 MHz. With the Link 16, Raptor will be able to share the data it's capturing with other platforms. The Air Force was looking to resolve the data link problem issue for some time now, but complex procedures and technicalities prevented a quick move. The breakthrough came in 2017. Till then, the U.S. Air Force was using the waterfall model of development. It's the conventional approach in which large changes are made in one go after every component is ready. For 2017 onwards, agile development methodology was embraced. It allowed for small incremental updates to be pushed quickly. Upgrades that could take decades or longer can now be accommodated in years with this approach. The agile approach has removed the bottleneck, paving the installation of Link 16. It's to be noted that even today, F-22 can't be exported to any country, as per American federal law, which is a stark contrast to other fighters, including the F-35. It still possesses many secrets. F-22 will now be used to the fullest of its potential, and it will also take up the role of a force multiplier.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.